Welcome back to Steven Sausage Roll. Let's continue. Alright, as usual, it's been a few days, and, I've taken a look at the prior footage, and, Wobblecliff is gonna be a bit of an issue, but I'll see what I can do about it today. I've also been pretty busy with a lot of stuff in my personal life, and I've also been preparing another project, which you may be seeing soon. We'll, see about that. And, just generally trying to get everything, well situated. But, I've got time, so let us continue. As soon as I can get myself aligned here. So, Wobblecliff. There's multiple avenues of exploration, as there often are in these tough puzzles that, take me a little while to complete, but I'll see what I can do. So, last time, the reason that I was having problems was that, there were kind of a few, like, interlocking constraints that I was just having trouble all satisfying at once. I saw ways to get individual parts of the puzzle done, but I just couldn't figure out how to put together a complete solution quite yet. So, that may involve either a radical reapproach of my, assessment of the situation, or, maybe it'll just be a lot simpler, who knows. Yeah, so the ultimate problem, like, what I would like to do is just hang this off the edge of that, of this gray bit here. I'm just gonna call this block the gray block, this one the, black and red one as appropriate, and this one the green one, and, this piece I'm standing on now the blue one. That's, the standard I set in the prior episode, and I'll try and stick to it this time, but, I'll see what I can do. So, the basic problem here is, that, like, this little bit kind of sticks out up here. So I can't shove this to the right. At least, not without colliding right into the black piece. So either it'll try and force it left, or in this case where I jammed everything up, it'll just, stop, because at some point it'll try and push the blue piece, and I'm standing on the blue piece, so we can't push the blue piece. You basically can't push anything that you're standing on if it's free-floating. You can't use an indirect push to push something that itself pushes an object that you're standing on. You can do the indirect pushes, you can do rowing, like I saw in the other episode, where, if you have something that can't move for some other reason that's not directly attached to the terrain you're standing on, you can, move the terrain you're standing on that way by trying to do a rotation that would normally be blocked, but because you're standing on loose, movable terrain, due to Newton's third law, that reaction winds up pushing the terrain out from underneath you. So that's a way you can push an object that you're standing on. However, that doesn't seem particularly appropriate for this puzzle because there's just a very limited number of, bracing points, really. Although, it is interesting that this sort of thing is possible. I can hold this up very, very temporarily, but the problem is, like, there's not really anywhere to go after that. But, interesting to note that that is possible. I could be holding this and, well, then drop it. So, there were other ways to start, but this one did seem like the most practical, thus far. Yes, or is there anything else I can hang this off of? Because, like, ideally what I wanted was for this to be hanging a certain distance off of, the south side of either one of these pieces, such that eventually it would just fall and then be at the same height, the same altitude, as the other green piece, the only two pieces of solid land in this puzzle. Ideally lined up with the sausage as well, but we'll see if we can make that happen or not. And interestingly, we have noted that we can shove the sausage to the left like so, but we haven't figured out a way to shove it to the right yet either. It should also be noted that if I do wind up shoving this to the over here, yeah, like I have to solve this at some point. Like, you notice I'm dropping the island on the hologram. Now, as we've learned in other puzzles, the hologram will come with you if you roll the sausage. So probably when I roll the sausage along these grills over here, it'll probably just come with me and that'll be my exit and everything will be fine. Just standing on this southwest part of the 2x2 grills here. But it's still important to pay attention to that kind of thing. Okay, so the real idea here is, you know, usually I have a pattern in episode one of a new puzzle of trying fairly conventional things out at first, and then in episode two, because I want to try things that aren't the same as what I did in the previous episode, I try and be a little bit more outlandish. So usually that's when I start, like, breaking out the really experimental stuff. Like, for example, I could do stuff like this. This is no longer directly connected to land, but perhaps I could still get it around. Yeah, so something like that could work, because if I could ever figure out a way to bring that back up... Well, I don't know how I'd bring it back up yet, but it's a thought anyway. Yeah, so the furthest over I can get this is this. That's the furthest over I can get the gray block without having something else to support it, which I have a hard time figuring out how I would do that, because none of these are shaped in such a way that they can hang off the east edge. I can hang something off the west edge, namely this green bit here, but everything else, it's going to have to hang off either the south edge or, well, nothing. Yeah, nothing. Yeah, so the only reason that this whole thing worked was that I was able to first lower this thing and hang it off of something. And in this case, that wound up being the sausage rather than the gray bit here. Purely because the gray bit and the black and red bit don't work together very well. Although, interestingly, this is also possible. Yeah, so right now this black and gray bit hasn't fallen down yet, but instead I can put it on my own head, like that. So that actually works pretty well. I mean, it works well in the sense that, like, it's sort of in the right place, but I don't think I'm done yet, am I? Because, like, that doesn't fall far enough, I think. Yeah, like, that's still... Yeah, like, of course it's still elevated by one. Because, this is lowered by one, yes. And this is hanging off of something that's level with the same playing field here, so of course that's fine. And this is also hanging off of that and is lowered by one, so of course this is level with the whole thing. Which is all well and good. Like, I actually accomplished what I wanted to accomplish, but the problem is that the sausage is... basically down one level from everything else here. So it's just sunk into the ground relative to all this. So I have not actually solved my problem. Like, in order to... Like, this implies that I have to... I think that actually implies that I have to push this off somehow, right? Because I have to lower everything by exactly one. But what does that mean? That means that, like, something else has to hang on the sausage then, right? But yeah, how do I make, like, a lowering staircase? I want an elevation level that drops by one. But none of these are actually set up to do that because, like, basically the hook is always going to be raised one level and then you just drop one level. And all of these are exactly too high. So, I mean, with that... minor trick, I accomplished what I wanted to accomplish, but really, like, there was a more fundamental problem that was plaguing this the whole time. Okay. well, what can I do about this? I could move the sausage, but in order to move the sausage, I have to have somewhere for it to actually rest on. So that does... I certainly don't have that now, and that kind of seems to presuppose that I already have, like, stable land for it to roll onto anyway. Yeah, right now this whole contraption is still being held up by the sausage. Now, I can move the blue piece from anywhere as long as I'm not standing on the blue piece. So theoretically, if I were standing somewhere else, like, say, here or something, yeah, I can start moving this around. But, like, I still need, Well, let's just experiment. This is somewhere new that we haven't gotten before, so let's just see what the potential is of this new arrangement. So yeah, in order to lower this by one, I would essentially need some kind of, support structure. Now... Yeah, so essentially I need something that I can hang the hook on. That's one tile lower than this altitude level, which is the same as the blue structure, the same as the gray structure, same as all of this. So, there's just some other source of, like, hanging that I don't have. And the only one I can think of is right here. Which would actually work, right? Because now I can just, now that I've made that assembly, now I can, because I shifted the whole thing over. Now I can just poke this over there and it'll hang on the bottom. Right. So now this actually is in alignment and I can roll it back. And I don't think it would it have mattered? Okay, yeah, it still would have mattered if the blue thing had sunk into the ocean because everything else is still being held up by the blue piece right now. So it was important that the blue piece go on solid ground. But that's okay. Everything else is stable. And we're all set. So there's just one last thing that I had to do, and indeed, it did lower the whole assemblage by one tile, and that was the only way to do it, and it was the way I did it. So go figure. Now we're gonna fall a little bit, right? I think that happened already. I guess that must have happened in a prior arrangement, but in any case, now that this is all fallen down, we can still get out, and that should be floating, so that's a little tunnel that we can go underneath. Interestingly, it is a one-tile overhang. I'm still not 100% sure of what determines the altitude of these things, after I'm done working with them, but, you know, it isn't causing any problems, so I guess it's harmless. I may have to worry about that in the future, but for right now, it's fine. Alright, so now I will read this tablet that I set aside as a reward for myself once I finish that puzzle. Alright, well, you know, it's hard to tell with this game. This could be another metaphor, or it could be actually literal. As in, there are... Well, maybe not, like, super literal, but, I guess, like, more directly metaphorical in the sense that there might be multiple worlds involved here. After all, we don't know what lies outside this, area that we're working with right now. Okay, well, let's just get a sense of what, this puzzle involves first before I start placing my, pieces. So you've got both the dragon that we probably have to hold up, as well as this ferry that we also probably have to hold up. So this is where the stacking is going to come into play that I was mentioning earlier. So what I'm going to need to do is bring one of these... I haven't come up with a name for this shape yet, but it keeps happening. So I guess it's just an L shape. One of these L-shaped two-tall stacks. Just a single sausage rotated 90 degrees stacked on top of another one. Anyway, let's get rid of this sausage. That shape is going to be easier to transport, and then we'll turn it into its, mirror. It's a dexterous, counterpart. And a little bit later. And we have just enough sausages to, do the job. As usual, really. Except that that's going to be, well, I'm not going to go up through the middle there. I'll go, go down here and then bring it up. Right, so as long as I do this move, I can just drag the whole machine over that way. And then I should be able to figure out some way of, oh yeah, I want to do that, yeah, so we don't bring it that far, we bring it this far. Then when we move this over like that, then it creates that shape. Okay, so we can get this puzzle started. Now, of course, this is but one shape that we could use to do this. The other shape would be horizontal on the bottom and vertical on top, and that would work just as well. But we'll try this one first, see where it gets us. Okay, well, now we've got four sausages to cook. This probably still needs to stay at the same height that it's at now. So that's all well and good so far. Although I still need to actually get to it. Right, because that wall is, no, okay. So that's actually just a single pole here, okay. So that's fine so far. And we can do things like this, and then bring that over, so this creates a connection that we can use to get over here. And we will have to do a certain degree of substitution, but maybe we might be able to just cook all three of the vertical sausages using the northwest set of grills, because I can certainly cook this free one, I think. I think I can get that back. Yes, I can. So using the by now familiar substitution techniques, we can, actually, hold on a minute. How are we going to get it out from here? I guess we can put it on top of the ferry and then drag the ferry downwards. That might work. I might be able to bring that. Well, I'm not going to be able to bring it adjacent. Well, I can't bring the bottom edge adjacent to land because the pole's in the way, but if I bring the whole thing adjacent to the island on this side, I should be able to get at a sausage over here and bring it back to the mainland, so I think we'll be okay. So that means I think we want to put this on the, well, no, not on the bottom edge, because we still can't get it back because the pole will be in the way. That's right. So we won't be able to push it to the east from this side. So that means we instead want to, well, no, don't do that. Is there a way to shove only the plank ferry upwards? Yes, there is. So you can set it kind of offset like that. Yeah, so that's good. In fact, if we do that, that might work too. That works, except I can't step on the ferry, so it has to be just down here. But that's okay. That is enough to take the sausage back. So we'll put it on this side. We should be able to walk straight through. Yep, okay. And then we drag it downwards like that. And then we, well, then we need to bring the whole thing over. Yeah, so if I do that, then that's a problem. Right. Okay, well, is there anywhere else I can do a different move, then? Well, I can do that, bring it down part of the way, and that gives me enough leverage to shove this downwards, and then I can probably bring it back up. Yeah, so, like, now I can actually get around it. Like so. Yeah, that's all well and good. And do that. Okay. So that takes care of the one under the dragon. Substituting the one underneath the, like, that's holding up the ferry right now is another matter. But at the very least, we'll do what we can for right now. Yeah, so far, so good. Yeah, that's, this is more, the other one was, more of a conceptual problem, but Wobblecliff is definitely both a combination of what you already know about, like, terrain pushing in a new context, but also just, a conceptual sort of thing. But this one seems to be just more of a tactics application. This one is just like, you know, okay, you think you're a professional at moving these things around, well, here's your, you know, your ultimate qualifier challenge. Here's your, you know, if you think you're really good at moving this stuff around, here's 4 sausages. And I think I can handle that. I think this is within my wheelhouse. Okay. Alright, so... so that gets us these free. Now, we still need to keep this held up. So that implies that we need to substitute the sausage in a very specific way, probably involving, like, I think we might need to move one of these sausages while still holding this thing up. Yeah, so there's absolutely no way of raising anything in this context. Like, if, oh, whoops. Yeah, like, if that horizontal sausage ever falls down before I'm ready for it, then, well, then you're just out of luck. Okay, that looks good. Yeah, that seems to have accomplished what I wanted. Okay. Alright. Little bit complicated there. I'm not sure the camera angle really showed that off really well, but basically I just wound up doing a displacement over there that also happened to displace this sausage, and I just happened to have both of that ready, so it's just doing 2 displacements at once. But it still worked exactly the same way as everything else has worked, as far as me standing on the piece that I don't want to move. Alright, so that's stable. I can just leave that there. I don't need to do anything else. I don't know what I'm gonna do with the ferry. I guess for the time being, all things being equal, I'd like to just hang it off the edge of that, so that when it comes back, it'll be in a good spot. The horizontal sausage, however, is not in a good spot. I still need to be able to actually bring that, further over. So hopefully doing something like that would be good. I mean, the dragon just sank, so, you know, I am a little bit disappointed about that, but we'll take these things as they come. Also, there's a dearth of unstabbing points, so that also makes this a little bit awkward to work with. Alright, but we're nearly done. I'm sure I can come up with something that I'll be reasonably satisfied with. Yeah, so that results in just a normal carry. That is not what I want. I think. Or, well, it... well, no, it won't work. Because... well, okay, if I bring it around the top, it will. Okay. Alright, well, let's see if this solution is good enough. I did lose the ferry, but we'll see if that has a problem with the overarching, meta puzzle on the overworld, or if, it's fine that I kind of left it on that area. If need be, I can resolve it. Okay, that's a reasonable spot. At least bridges over there, so good enough. Oh boy. Alright, but yeah, you can see that if I just dumped that ferry in any arbitrary spot, like down here, then this area would not connect to the upper left-hand corner. So even though I would have solved this puzzle, I would not have solved it correctly, so I would not be able to get over here. Alright, well, we're making good time. I suppose we can see what the deal is with this tablet. Absolutely. I agree. Finally, Sign Maker and I are on the same page. And here's that village that I spotted the other day. Well, this looks suitably ominous. Okay, well, doesn't seem to be anything particularly special about those housing structures. Although it is a little bit weird that they have four doors and no windows. Alright, what am I working with here? God pillar. Oh, all of them sank, of course, because they weren't built on solid foundations. Naturally. So, God pillar, you say. You do start with one of these sausages that isn't. It's just a hologram. So there's no ladders on. Oh, there is a ladder of one. Okay. I was about to say, there's definitely no ladders on any of these here, but no, there are ladders. So that would be why we want to keep these. I'd sure like to get up there. That's the logical next place to go. I guess I'm gonna have to build my own ladder. That seems like the right dimension there. I think that's only a two-tile gap, so yeah, I think as long as I slide the houses over here, I should be able to build something. Alright, well, let's get to it. We have 8 sausages and 8 houses. All of these start horizontal, but there's no reason they have to stay that way, necessarily. Perhaps there's a way to rotate them. But yeah, that's certainly shaping up to be a final puzzle. But where would I take these sausages to reorient them? Everything's level here. All of this, same altitude. Same altitude. I think this is how I climbed up on the sausage in the first place. So I could not take a sausage here. Yeah, can't do that because it's horizontal. And as we've seen, you can't bring a horizontal sausage up a ladder like this unless you're stabbed into it horizontally. And that can create more problems than it solves. You need a special dispensation to fix that problem. So I guess let's not worry about it then. I'm gonna just try with 8 horizontal sausages, and if it looks like that's gonna be a problem, we'll reevaluate. But for now, we'll just, we'll take the puzzle at face value. You certainly, do not necessarily want to do that in general, but it's a fine place to start. Yeah, let's just push all of these, that'll save me some time. Alright, well, I think it's not since, the Great, Cold Gate, that's it, where we've had to work with 7 sausages, and it's certainly not been since the Great Tower that we've had to work with 8, but this may be more about the grandiosity of, like, making a big puzzle than necessarily minimalism. This is not minimalism, this is grandeur, is what this is. So I think this may not necessarily be closely related to the number 8, or the magic that you can do with 8 sausages that you couldn't do with 7. I do believe you hit diminishing returns as the number of sausages you have grows. But nonetheless, we'll just start things in the obvious setup and see what we get. So, I don't know how many of these we're gonna need, but my initial assumption is we're gonna need all of them. That seems fair to me. Interestingly enough, I don't think I'm gonna have any problems at all, cooking any of these. Okay, so it's like I thought. So, as usual with, these objects, the floor falls away, but the ceiling stays present if you can hold the ceiling up. So when we provide our own pillars, the roof still can retain meaning and value and all of those lovely things. So, is it really that simple, though? Well, okay. Well, it's not hard at all to, it's not gonna be hard at all to get all this, over here. In fact, this move even works. So, it's not gonna be hard to get the first one up here. The second one is going to be the hard one. But after we get the second one, I don't think the third one and the fourth one and so on and so forth are going to be that hard at all. So yeah, I can just get this over here directly. That's what I was trying to find out in the first place. So we can climb up a little bit. But in order to get any higher, we're going to have to carry one of these things with us, naturally. So, multiple problems are being raised here. Okay, so that happens. So, I think in order to solve these problems, I'm not actually stating out loud yet, although the obvious one is, like, A, how do we raise something, which I think we can accomplish by stabbing. But I think the second one is just, how do you get down after you put the second one in place, and I think this is the answer. I think what we want to do is start, like, we're not going to be building a pillar. I think we're going to be building a pyramid. Yeah, so now, if we put another one in the center, what do we get? Yeah, because I have no doubt that if I just cook all 9 of the sausages now, we're just going to be stuck with a mountainside that I can't climb up, so... You know, even though this terrain manipulation has kind of been in the background and only very incidental with the last thing I just did, this one is very much in the forefront. The puzzle is not the hard part. It's the meta puzzle. But in any case, it just winds up being about the same thing anyway, because my verbs of interaction are the same. Okay, well, question the second. How do I get one of these up this ladder if it's a horizontal sausage? Because I can't carry any of these, because they're already at ground level. And the only vertical sausage I have available is this one, but I guess I might as well use it. And also, there's... It's not obvious at all from here, but there's, once again, a dearth of stabbing surfaces. Like, none of this is stable. This whole island is, well, rock solid, but it's one level below me. And everything else, like, this won't move. But, like, there's no horizontal bracing in this puzzle. Like, the closest thing I can think of is, like, this thing. But that's it. And this is also just a one-tile thin cliff, interestingly enough. Alright, well, nobody ever said building a tower that would go into heaven would be easy. That's interesting. So there's a ladder on this side, too. Okay. That might actually be super helpful. Yeah, so maybe we want to build something like that shape, then. Yeah, I mean, of course this appeals to my sense of aesthetics as an architect, but I don't know if that's gonna be correct or not. So yeah, how do I lift one of these objects if I can't stab a sausage? It should also be mentioned that while I could embed my fork in one of these, like, pre-embedded in, for example, I can stab against the hologram, because the hologram is solid right now. But that will mean A, I'm gonna lose that house over there. And, B, this doesn't necessarily solve my problems, because I'll be able to do this once. Like, I can bring this out here, then move this aside out of the way of the other one. And do all that. The other thing is that I'm kind of aligned the wrong way. So, yeah, like, I can't... There's no ladders in this direction. There are in the other two, but not this way. Yeah, so one way or another, I have to figure out how to stab the single vertical sausage you get horizontally, I think. Because that seems to be the correct way of moving these things around. So, this is the closest thing I have to a stabbing surface. Can I build some kind of an extensor that, basically lets me, extend the bracing, further out to a more accessible spot? Like, that basically just seems to consist of, just putting these things on the spots that I was already putting them on, right? Like, this is as far out as this goes. Well, I could put another house over here. No, it wouldn't, because this isn't braced against the cliff yet. So I can create a vertical bracing, no problem. But that only gives me something I can stab horizontal sausages against. It doesn't give me anything that I can pull back from to unstab. Because, there is nothing down here to run into. So, at some point, that means that, I have to, already lift one of these things up here and then put it over here, then get on top of that, and then use this as the, unstabbing spot. Which I guess maybe I could see. Let's give that a try. That's the closest thing we've seen to, progress today, so... Well, I mean, that presupposes that I can manage to stab the vertical sausage in the first place, though, doesn't it? Which I have not yet figured out how to do. Alright, so I wound up doing the same thing I did earlier, but at the very least I'm doing it for a different reason now, so I'll call that progress. So, yeah, how... Okay, well, there's an idea. We do have multiple ladders, so that means I can log roll. What does that get me? Not... It doesn't seem like much at the moment, but let me think. So, with one vertical sausage and eight horizontal, I can build a log rolling, network, almost. Because I can go vertically pretty much as however I want, and I can dismount horizontally in a variety of ways. But, in order to move horizontally, the only way I'll be doing that is, across horizontal sausages without log rolling. The only horizontal log roll I get of indefinite distance, and not definite distance defined by the widths of the horizontal sausages, is, I get exactly one vertical sausage I can use for that purpose. So I can pretty much log roll however I want. So the difficulty is purely in coming up with a way in which I can make that useful. Well. Yeah, so I can stab vertically whenever I want. I could even stab... Well, if I stab vertically, I can't climb one of these ladders, though. That was the whole problem here. And I did verify for absolutely sure that there was no ladders on this side, right? No. No. These houses only have vertical ladders. Yeah, ladders on the vertical sides of their faces, not anything else. So there is a ladder over there, there's not a ladder over here, and there's definitely not a ladder over there. So each of these has four ladders, one on each pillar, each on either the north side or the south side as appropriate. The different plank shapes on each of these houses gives me a little bit of pause. This one is even, you could even say qualitatively different from this one. It's not a rotation. But I don't know if that's any help or not. I think it's probably just for detail. Okay. So yeah, we have options. We just have to be creative with what we have. We have... I wouldn't quite say ultimate freedom here, but we're pretty darn close as this game gets. We're not gonna get, a jetpack, or ultimate freedom in the form of being able to just place or build ladders wherever we want, but we can still maneuver in a large number of different ways. So I guess what I would like to do is build a stack of sausages. Like, I'd like to stab a sausage and then go up here and then figure out a way of releasing it and then drop it down there. That increases the number of options I have, and it also lets me carry sausages around. And it increases the height at which I can log roll. But ultimately, like, the whole reason I'm doing any of this is that I just want to find a way to stab one of these, or lose my fork. If I lose my fork, I might be able to figure out, finagle a way of stabbing. Although it could still get a little tricky. But yeah, once I do that, I'll be able to place the vertical sausage in the bottom slot here. Like, I'll be able to just put it here. Well, come to think of it, even doing something like this might be hard. Like, I'd have to shove it up here, and then, like carry it backwards over here, but, like, I'd have to insert the sausage into the bottom of it. So, like, see, that's the fundamental problem here, is that if I'm holding on to the sausage, I don't know where it is right now. I think I just didn't push it far enough. Like, in order to insert it into the, well, that's too far. Yeah, there we go. That's what I want. So yeah, I'd have to come down into it. So interestingly, I can do that. This does work. But I'm still trying to see what the value would be of that. Like, that means I can log roll just by walking off the edge of that. And it means I can climb down there, which is interesting. But only facing that way, for sure. But I still don't see how that opens up any new stabbing opportunities. Alright, so now, this thing can't move south because it'll run into the base of this island. And it can't move up because of the pillar, or the cliff, I guess is what I'll call it. And it can't move left or right because the legs are in the way of, like, the legs would run into the little spot of one-by-one ground that it's resting on right now. So that can't move anymore. It's basically the same as just locked land that we're familiar with. So that's what happens if I push one of them over there into the center. Otherwise, it stays at this height, and it stays at the same height as this thing. But in order to use this as an unstabbing mechanism, like, particularly if I'm facing north, well, I can use this as an unstabbing mechanism if I can move west from this position, so, like, yeah, that is one advantage of doing this, is I can do this. So that's potentially useful. That doesn't tell me how to stab, but does tell me how to unstab, at least. I don't know if that'll be enough room to do what I want, but it's something, I guess. There is a nut, well, Yeah, actually, hold on, because this can't move either. So now I've actually created a horizontal bracage. Okay. So now I can actually stab and unstab at my leisure. Okay. That means I do have to stab the bottom half, though. But that would still work just as well if I, like, if that were one tile lower, right? So if I, restart. You. Doesn't really matter. They're all the same, but just for the sake of convenience, you. And just to keep myself flexible, I'll even flip the rolls of each thing. So this one will be the one that rests on the ground, and the other one will do the other thing. So that works, and then I can just bring this other one. I said bring this other one to a different spot that still braces in pretty much the same way, and we can use that as a horizontal bracage. Yeah, so the nice thing about doing this is that I have not yet actually decided on a spot to put that in yet. So the even nicer thing, let me get this sausage out of the way first. Yeah, I get the impression I'm actually not going to need very many of these. I might need, like, two of these. Like two horizontals and one vertical, maybe. But I don't see myself actively needing all eight of these. Alright, so the next thing we do, right, is we're trying to get a third platform here. Because I don't just want to stab the lower half of the vertical sausage. I want to stab the upper half of it. So for that, I'll want a little bit more leverage. So something like that. And then we'll want a little even more than that. But if we keep continuing the diagonal pattern, we don't have enough room, do we? Well, sort of. Like, I could bring the vertical sausage here first, then the next house under it, and I could stab that way. Like, this westward move would stab. But then what would I do after that? Like, I could move this down, and that would all be well and good. I could clean this up. I'm pretty sure I could clean this up. Yeah, I could clean this up. It would not be easy, but I could do it, I think. Well, hold on. Well, getting this thing down might actually be kind of hard. Yeah, that would actually be kind of hard. But anyway, if I just ignored that for a little while, what I could just do is just climb one of these multiple ladders here. Interestingly enough, I would kind of be facing the wrong way. And also, I don't know why I was trying to... Oh yeah, I was trying to stab the lower one because... the upper half of the vertical sausage because I wanted to use it to lift one of these things up onto this platform. Right. But I don't have a place to unstab once I'm up here, is the issue. If I'm stabbed into the upper half of it. On the lower half would not work... Because I had crashed into this. Yes. But I'm willing to give it a try anyway. Because maybe I can just lift it up there and leave it there. And then... And then, like, keep it stabbed. And I'll never actually have to unstab. So maybe that's the idea. Alright, time to get another house. Sure feels like I have more of them than I need at the moment, but I'm sure, like, once I get a good method going, I should be able to figure something out. And I guess the intentionally limited camera view is actually coming into play here for once, because, that means I'm actually not sure about how high I have to go until I've done it. Which is a, definitely a very intentionally cultivated feeling. Well, I mean, if I just wanted to do this, I could have stopped already, right? Like, I could just go pick up one of these other houses. Like, say, this one. Right, but yeah, that was the other thing, was I wasn't sure how to... yeah, how to bring that up there. So I almost need to find a way of bracing these things in such a way that I can do the stab with the sausage already in place or something. Or just bring this parallel to another one, I guess. So, for example, I could actually bring this up all the way. Well, not even all the way, just there. Then, with that one tile of gap, I can go here, go down, bring this along, and do this. And then leave that there. Okay, well, this has done something. I guess I want to get rid of this now, but... yeah, that was the other problem. I can't until I figure out how to, well, if I build the same structure in reverse, maybe I could make that work. The problem is that this is not actually mirrored, because this shape over here is not directly aligned with the pillar here. It's one tile over. So if I build the same mirrored, like, diagonal structure of houses... we're gonna wind up with one fewer space on this side. Subtle. So, here's how you get your asymmetries out of your symmetries. We're getting there. Like, this might not even be, like, a pyramid or, like, a straightforward ladder. Maybe it's more like a spiral staircase. But, yeah. Okay, well... you know, I think I'm gonna take a break now, but, this seems like a good start to this puzzle. Yeah, there's gonna be a lot... This definitely feels like a final exam. I think everything... all my powers of sausage manipulation and terrain manipulation are going to be necessary to solve this one.